Hey everybody, come on in. I try to be on as long as my internet will let me. An open heaven. Blessings, come on in. Hey everybody. Connection has been giving me problems, okay? Problems. We are under an open heaven. Yes, Lord, anytime the devil try to come and do his work, God just open up the heavens over his people. Hallelujah. I want everybody to type open heaven. Yes, Lord, we are under an open heaven. We declare and decree an open heaven. Hallelujah. Let the power of God overflow. Yes, Lord Jesus. Where the broken shall be made whole. We are under an open heaven. What? An open heaven. I'm sorry.
We made dances.
We made dances? I see the glory in the video. I see the glory in the video. All right. Say bye.
Bye.
You like my move? Girl, all I had to do was... That's the app. She said she liked your moves, Leah. Now she put a little bit more work into hers. An open heaven. Thank you. We know you're able, Jesus. Cover us, Lord. Are y'all having trouble? Yeah, she did a little bit more. Are y'all having trouble? Because I don't know if the connection's bad. I'm just going to come on tomorrow. We need your glory, Lord. We need your power, Lord. Hallelujah. We are in an open heaven. Please share the broadcast as you come on. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Somebody needs to say that. I just heard the Holy Spirit say that. Someone is of joy. Hey, Marilyn. Glad you could come on. Bless you. An open heaven. Open your heavens over us, God. Open your heavens over us, Lord. Hallelujah. Open heaven. Miracles. Signs and wonders. Miracles. Signs and wonders. Just call it over your life. Miracles. Signs and wonders. Miracles. Yes, Lord. Release your miracles and your signs and your wonders. No matter if it's a demonic attack, if it's a biological warfare, no matter if it's a 5G attack, Father, in the name of Jesus. You are the Lord of our life. You are the God of our salvation. You are the strength of our life. You are our battle in a time of war. You are our battle axe. You win every battle, God, and you cause us to triumph. You cause us to triumph over the enemy, no matter what it looks like. You make us to win. Hallelujah. I believe in miracles, signs, and wonders. And we just speak them over this broadcast and the lives of the people tonight, God. Let miracles, signs, and wonders flow over the lives of your people, Lord, that everything, 1,000 will fall at our left and 10,000 at our right, but nothing shall come nigh. Nothing shall come nigh us in the name of Jesus. We speak the blood of Jesus over every attack, over our children, over our grandchildren. We speak the blood of Jesus over our cities in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord is our light. No, that's enough. The Lord is our light and our salvation. Yes, he is. He is the strength of our life. We have no one or nothing to be afraid of. The Lord is the strength of our life. We shall not fear. We shall not fear. Somebody need to encourage themselves in the Lord and say, I shall not fear. I will not be afraid of what man can do unto me. There's so many different stories, and I was asking the Lord, I said, God, now I'm hearing some stuff about this 5G. This 5G, God, you know, so many different stories out, and the Lord said, the main thing that he wanted me to know is that he said that they're going to try to lock you in, and we have to do that. We have to do that for our own protection, because, you know, this virus has been out. It's been out, you know, since the end of last year, it's been out, and people been knowing about it, and we just have to do what we know is right to do at all times. And the blood of Jesus is over us to protect us, to protect our children. The Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And that's what we live our lives for. We live our lives to be in the presence of God. So we just need to be encouraged that God is with us. And it's more than the whole world against us. I don't care what they're trying, what they want to do, what they say they want to do. However they want to do it, it does not matter. So I asked the Lord. I said, Lord, now what is this about this 5G? And he said, well, nobody knew your grandfather as a prophet. He said, but he prophesied to his family. And he said, he told a word to your mother. And I want to remind you of this. This is what the Lord told me. He said, your grandfather told a word to your mother. And I want to remind you of this word. That man would overdo themselves with computers. Now, when he was alive, he died of cancer. And I believe it's because he didn't openly accept the prophetic call, but he shared those words with his children. And lung cancer is what took him out. Because the ruach, the breath of God, you know, he prophesied but didn't fully walk in his calling. And that's the revelation that God gave me concerning his death. He died, he was like maybe 54, I never met him. But he said that computers would destroy man. That was a word, and I asked the Lord that today, and that's what the Lord told me. He said, the same word that he gave your mom is the word I'm going to give to you. So, we already know when we see it at Walmart. When you go to Walmart now, they don't even want to check you out. They want you to go to self-checkout. They have more self-checkout lines than they have for people work. Okay, we already see these things. And so, the only thing that shows me is that it is a lot of things that people have done with computers that they did not intend on doing. It's a lot of things that computers are doing that is taking over man, and I don't believe that God is pleased with that. I don't believe that that's the will of God, and I don't believe that separation is the will of God. And if you're keeping up with the news, I heard it. I didn't see it for myself, but they were telling me that Texas passed a law where, you know, church and state supposed to be separate. So they're saying they're getting out of the way of Texas gathering for churches. So if the churches want to gather, then they have that liberty. The governor said he's taking the restrictions. The restrictions don't apply to churches. And I believe that that should be something that the body of Christ should be praying for. But I don't believe that the body of Christ want to pray for that, because it's too many churches that are religious and don't flow in the gifts of the Spirit. There is an outpouring of the Holy Spirit that I'm praying for, that the Holy Spirit is constantly confirming and reassuring me that it's coming. A wave of the glory is coming to the body, but the body have to want it. The body have to be looking for it. We have to be ready and willing and crying out for God to do mass healings, for God to just lift up this burden off of his people. And it was prophesied by a prophet that I really do love and respect, Prophet Makandiwa. He's from Africa, and he was saying God showed him in a vision. He said this 3 years ago. God showed him in a vision that this would wipe out, you know, it had the potential to take out hundreds, thousands, even millions. And it would come, and people would just drop dead. And it had some confirmation videos that were shown as well. And so we have to understand that whatever it is, we don't have to be. They are not, because they are very religious. When God sent me to Texas to preach there, he told me I was preaching to a stiff-necked people, that they had a form of godliness, but they deny the power. That's what he told me. But the time will come. The time will come. Benny Hinn said it a long time ago, that God has been wanting to send the prophetic fire in Texas, but Texas rejects it. They reject it, you know, that God really wanted to raise up a tsunami of the glory through the prophetic. But it's just a business spirit over Texas. It's good for business, and it's good for, you know, a lot of other things, but they're not good in trying to accept the glory and the supernatural. But the time will come. The time will come when God is going to take over Texas and he's going to establish his authority over there. And I'm not saying that there are not people there that believe in it. I'm just saying that the glory, the way, the level of the glory and the supernatural that God wants there is not there. But the governor have enough sense. But not long ago, there was another politician that was saying that the preachers had to submit their sermons to her. He had to submit their sermons to her. They had to submit their sermons to her because she needed to make sure that they wouldn't preaching against, the LGBT community. But that was, of course, overturned, thank God, because that's none of her business. That's none of her business. The preachers, unless they're 501c3, that controls what you say. But if you're not 501c3, you preach that Bible and you preach Christ and him crucified. And whoever gets hurt by it, then that could be a conviction that's going to lead them to salvation. But anyway, I believe that we're in a season of blessing. And you need to remember that. You need to keep that on your mind that we're in a season of blessing. We're in a time of blessing. God wants to bless his people no matter what is going on, no matter what it looks like or what it feels like. We're in a season of blessing. How many times can you think back since you started working as an adult that you had time to stay home in the house with your children, spend time with them, be in their face with your spouse? People don't get time for that because everybody is running, trying to make a dollar, make a nickel, make a name for themselves. And I just feel like God just put everything on hold. Everything has been put on hold for people to come face to face with those that really matter the most, with their family members, with their loved ones. And some people are not adjusting well, but God is going to deal with them. He'll deal with those that are not adjusting well. But this is a time where we just need to be rejoicing. Because I believe that everything that the government lied and said that they couldn't do, they're going to be forced to do it. And we're just going to be innocent partakers. We're going to be innocent partakers of every blessing that God have in certain cities. It started in certain cities. But God is, he's still Lord. He's still Jesus over your life. And you need to remember that. You need to not be overtaken with fear. As a matter of fact, I cancel the spirit of fear off of your life right now in Jesus' name. I just speak death to the power of fear. And we just cancel and scatter the power of death in the name of Jesus. We just command the death angel that's assigned to your life, to the city that you're in. We command it to scatter by the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, God did not give us a spirit of fear. We have to keep the faith. We have to believe that God is working things out beyond what we can see. We have to understand that his ways are not our ways. And he did not put this here. He didn't put this here, but he's going to use it for his glory. He's going to get the final say. He's going to be the one to make sure that his people are okay. He's going to be the one to make sure that you stay in perfect peace, but you have to work with him. And I'm going to tell you again, because I said it like maybe a week or two ago, that be reading Psalm 91. That is your anchor in this time. That is your anchor. If you're just coming on and you didn't share it, please share the broadcast. He's your anchor in this time. The Lord is your anchor, and Psalm 91 is your anchor. It will give you peace. And I even saw, I did some of the 24-hour prayer with Apostle John Eckhart. I was, watching online some of it, and a couple of people on there released it as well, that, we should be letting Psalm 91 be our anchor. And they just released some of that 24-hour prayer that they had on Wednesday night. But listen, trust in the Lord and do good. Do what you know to do, and God will be with you. God is going to keep you in perfect peace. Sleep it off. Spend time laughing. Enjoy the presence of God. Put your worship music on. Clean your house. Sanitize everything. Spray people come into your house. What we do, and we did it in the medical field, whenever there was a bad outbreak of a virus or the flu, we just sprayed Lysol in the air. And then the people walk through it. Everybody, if you came in the house, they walk through it. Kill the germs on your clothes. And you go straight to the sink and you wash your hands. You take your shoes off. Okay? And then, that way people coming from the outside is not bringing anything on the inside. Okay? And so we have to use precautions. But, if you clean, you should be fine. somebody made the comment today in regular conversation. It's the nasty people that's dying. Just be clean. Just be clean. And be aware of what you're doing, what you're touching, and what you're exposing your children to. Some cities have it worse than others, but I mean, the cities that I have partners in, where they are on lockdown and things like that, they're doing well. They're faring very well. So we just have to keep the faith. We have to believe, you know, that God, He's truthful. He's honest, and His words are truth, and they are life, and they give us peace. Okay, and so we have to understand that everything works out in the end for us. It's all going to work for the glory of God, for His kingdom agenda to be pushed forward, for the will of God to be done. And it doesn't matter who paid what money to get into what. It does not matter what happened behind the scenes. God is still watching, and He's working, and He wants to favor His people. He wants His people walking in favor and in peace. And you have to just know that I'm blessed by God. I'm blessed in the city. I'm blessed in the fields. I'm blessed when I come. I'm blessed whenever I go. It doesn't matter. I hear what the news is saying. I'm supposed to be aware, but I will not be moved. I will not be shaken. I'm anchored in the Lord. I'm anchored in the Lord. That just needs to be some of y'all confession. Some of y'all just need to spend time. Now you have time. So just spend time doing your confessions, because that's what God released at the end of December and at the beginning of this year. Those confessions. Some of y'all sowed a 2020 seed for the confessions. I sent them to you. You don't have an excuse. You have time. You're in the house. Make those confessions, because it's going to continue to determine what happens the rest of your year and what happens the rest of this decade. But it makes sense how God said that this decade is the decade of pay, the decade of mouth, of what you speak, the manifestation of what you speak. And so you have to understand how important it is that you're saying the right thing, because they are definitely putting out enough of the wrong thing. They're putting out enough of, oh, it's going here. It's going to be so many, this many cases. And, you know, it's spreading like wildfire. You know, they're saying enough. And so what are you saying concerning yourself, concerning your children, concerning your family, concerning what you're going to do? You know, we had one of my partners, his sons, we were believing God for him to, he's supposed to graduate this year. And we were believing God for him to do better on his standardized test. Some people just don't do well on that. And here they just canceled the test. That's miracles God is performing. I'm telling you, it's miracles. You don't know who is going to die trying to go on senior trip. Okay. And some of these senior trips are being canceled. Understand that God is always working things out for our good. And if you had full coverage on your car, you can get another car, baby. That car probably had it. So if you have full coverage, then you can get a whole nother car. All it needs to do is show up, and it can show up totaled, it can show up demolished, it can show up whatever. God will bless you with a brand new one, and that's what you should be believing God for, okay? And it's another time to get your house in order. Make sure you have health and make sure you have life insurance. Go find some life insurance. Make sure that you're covered. And if you're one of my partners, make sure that your family members know that you're a partner as well. That way, if something happened to you, tell them I need to be the first to know. You know, so just keep things in order. Nothing that you do should be hidden, because God said everything that's hidden is going to come to the light anyway. It's going to come to the light. So, you know, people around you need to know who you're connected with. Look, if something happened, I want this person to know, you know, this is what it is. This is how it should be. You be accountable for a good steward over what God has given you. Okay, so just be a good steward over what God has given you. You're in my life. You're important to me. I want to know. Somebody else needs to know how to get in touch with me if something happens, so I can be praying, so I can be aware. That's what mothers do. Okay, for those that are my spiritual children and those that are my partners. But I just believe, you know, that we're on the brink of miracles, and miracles are happening, and they're already happening. You're just waiting on the manifestation. And I just speak that they will manifest, and you will hear of them, and you will know them, and you will be a partaker of it. Somebody say, I'm a partaker. I'm a partaker. Do you need to just release that? Because that's what God is doing. When God is working behind the scenes and people are praying, God is moving mountains. He's making things happen. He's causing things to happen. And that's what faith is about. God, I know you're working this all out for me. In the end, I'm going to win. In the end, everybody else are going to be disturbed or distraught or have whatever they have. But I have my faith in God. And I'm in covenant rights. And I'm in covenant to have the blessings of Abraham, that my land is going to expand because of what I'm experiencing, that my money is going to expand because of what I'm experiencing, that I will even be healthy and germs and tissues and germs and diseases and bacteria, it died when it touched my body. It does not multiply when it touched my body. And I have wisdom. I have ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. And I walk by faith and not by sight. You have to get your mouth in order with what God is saying. And some of y'all come back and make those decrees. Listen to what I'm saying and make those decrees over your life. Because I just declare and decree that you should be expecting something great to happen. You should be expecting something great to happen because that's the God that we serve. God said, thank you, Holy Spirit. Trouble don't last always. Trouble don't last always. Remember, the Bible says that if you faint at a time of adversity, that means if you get weak, that means if you stop believing, that means if your belief system change, if you start being something different because something is happening, the Bible says if you faint at a time of adversity, your strength is small. That means that when things come that look like it should move you and it move you, then your strength is small. But I see our strength is the strength of God is made perfect in our lives whenever we're weak, whenever we're experiencing turmoil, when we're experiencing things around us and we don't know the direction to go. That's why the Bible says, let the weak say I'm strong. That's why the Bible says, let the poor say I'm rich, because it's when you're in a low place that the real manifestation of who Jesus Christ is, it comes upon you. Somebody just need to pull that anointing down. The anointing of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We just pull that down. We just pull it down. You're stronger than you are, than you think. You're stronger than you think, and you're well able. You have more in you than you will ever know. And I know because the Bible says that on the inside of us, God put a treasure on the inside of these earthen vessels. Your body is an earthen vessel, that the treasure of God is on the inside. Thank you. That was an app, baby. All we had to do was throw our hand up like that. The app did the rest. So if you want to see how you look moving real good, just go download the app. You don't even really have to move. The app does it for you. But God, he put a treasure on the inside of you that whenever your faith is stirred by reading the word, by praying, by fasting, by listening to the gospel, that spirit on the inside of you is stirred up. Is stirred, that treasure that's on the inside of you is stirred. Now, if you constantly listen to negative news, you're hearing everything that's going on and you're not processing it through the eyes of the Holy Spirit, and you're not guarding your gates through the Holy Spirit, then you're hindering what your treasure can do. You're hindering what that treasure on the inside of you can do, because the power of God on the inside of you is to bring you revelation, is to bring you to a place of peace, is to bring you to a place of wholeness, is to give you strength in the midst of every storm and every problem, of every situation. So you have to know that somebody needs to tell themselves, I'm strong. I'm strong. Somebody else needs to tell themselves, I'm well able. I'm going to get through this. I'm going to get past this. This too shall pass. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Ora bro shokoto lo makashenda la bekeske tele bokoshkoto. Yep, Romania. That's what the Lord said. He said, you're going to recover it all. He said, you're going to recover it all. In not many days from now, you're going to recover it all. Romania, that's the word of the Lord to you. He said, you're going to recover it all. Just trust me and keep on giving me praise. He said, you're going to recover it all. Leonard, God is saying that there's a transition coming over your life. He said, there's a divine transition that is taking over your life now. There's a divine transition where the will of God is coming in contact with what your will is. There has been, God is showing me, Leonard, that you have been the chase, the seeking that you have been doing for him. The seeking that you have been doing for him, he's ready to pour out his spirit upon you with a greater measure. There's a greater level of the glory coming over your life, Leonard, where you're walking that apostolic anointing. And God says, begin to pray for people. He says, begin to pray for people because miracles will manifest as you pray. God says, a lot of times there's a lot of things that I have to move out of your way for you to be able to see clearly. Leonard, he said, but many things had to get in divine alignment, and that's where you are right now, where your life is finally at a place where it makes sense, where God is giving you his mind, he's giving you his thoughts, he said he's giving you his visions, he's giving you the dreams. He said that he is right where your destiny and your reality is right on point. So you're going to begin to see the manifestation of your prayers. You're going to begin to see the manifestation of finances. Money is going to be easy for you. God says, make sure that you're faithful and you're a good steward over it. Make sure that you're a good steward over it. He said, all things have to be balanced in your life. And that is the word of the Lord for you, Leonard, that make sure everything is balanced. God expects you to balance everything that he's pouring over your life. He expects you to balance it. And Miss Marion, God is telling me that right now, he said that there is wealth coming to you. He said, I don't know where it's coming from. I don't know who owe you money, Miss Marion, but God said there is a level of wealth that is coming to you. So you just need to receive it. God said money is coming into your life that you don't have anything to worry about, that there is some lost money being recovered. Lost money being recovered for you. Hallelujah. My nephew is in here saying he received it for you. Hallelujah. The blessings of the Lord. Somebody need to say this right here. The blessings of the Lord make me rich and they add no sorrow with it. The blessings of the Lord make me rich and they add no sorrow with it. Somebody need to say that. And if you did not share the broadcast yet, please share. I don't know how long I don't have my stand, so I don't know how long I'm going to hold this phone. Let me see. The blessing of the Lord makes you rich and it adds no sorrow with it. Amen. The blessing of the Lord makes you rich, adds no sorrow with it. Hallelujah. Crystal, God is with me. Where are you watching me from? Where are you watching me from? Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. Oh, we bless your name. Oh, we bless your name. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. You are worthy, Lord. South Carolina. There's a season of darkness that you're coming out of. I don't know if you watch all the time. Or if you know, but there's a season of darkness that you're coming out of, says the Spirit of the Living God. In the realms of the Spirit, I see you walking out of a dark place, and I see you leaving behind clouds. I see you leaving behind a lot of clouds and moving into a place of new territory. I see you moving into a place where there is a lot more peace, because where you're coming out of is a lot, it has been a lot of darkness and a lot of terror. For you, a lot of heartache, but I break that spirit right now. I break that spirit off of your life right now that has been plaguing you and causing you so much heartache. God says, I'm favoring you in relationships and this new path that I have for you, Crystal, in South Carolina, did you say? He says that I'm favoring you in this new path. And he says, my glory will be with you and move with you. Says the Spirit of the Living God. I'm favoring you in relationships, says the Spirit of the Living God. Hallelujah. And God tells me to just speak peace over your life. I just command the peace of God that surpasses all understanding over your life in Jesus' mighty name. And I just cancel the spirit of sickness off of you, the spirit of fear. I command it to loose its hold and its grip off of your life now. In the name of Jesus, I don't know what you've been dealing with, what kind of sickness in your body or what it is that you've been concerned about, but God is healing that right now. The Spirit of the Lord wants you to know that that season is over, that you're embarking on a new journey, that you're going into new levels. Things are changing for you. Your best days are just about to, you're just about to walk into your best days. Hallelujah. God says to remind you that he has not forgotten about you. Sometimes, a lot of times we get bothered, we get sidetracked, and we just say, God, you know, did you forget about me? Did you forget about me, God? You know, I'm waiting on my time, Lord. I'm waiting on my season. I'm waiting on my opportunity, God. So when will my time come? God says you just need to know, and this part of this is for Crystal, but some of y'all that has been your testimony. Pam, God said, oh, you're about to laugh with joy. God said you're going to have so much laughter. He said you're going to have so much joy. You're even going into a place, Pam, where you're just going to be rejoicing. And I see you dancing in the spirit realm. I see money falling all around you. I see so many great things happening for you, Pam. I see is a series of events that your money will change. You're going to do good. We prayed for it the other day. Your money will change. And then I see your love life changing. I see some man, he have a hat on, you know, them hats that older men wear that kind of look like something Denzel would wear. I didn't say he looked like Denzel. I said he had a hat like Denzel. So it's like a top hat with the round rim like this. And so I see you not too much far from now, maybe within 6 months, I'm hearing the Lord saying that, you know, I don't know if this man is already in your life or you're talking to him. I don't know if he's there or not, but he's coming. He's coming. So God is going to fix your money. So you won't have to be concerned and nobody will think that they owe you anything or that you're dependent on them for anything. And then God is going to bless your life concerning the area of love. So just hold fast to your confession of faith. Believe God over what you feel and what you see. And God told me that you need to just remember that he is your shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Somebody needs to say that. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Glorify you. Hallelujah. Hola, Meshekete. Idara Robo Shanda. Broko Shakatala Beke. See, Dubs. God told me I rebuke that spirit of fainting off of you in the name of Jesus. God says, do not be weary in well doing. See, Dubs, what is your real name? From the inside of me, set me on fire. From the inside, Chelsea. Yes, God, the spirit of getting tired, getting weak and fainting because you felt like the will of God is not being performed in your life so fast, I cancel that spirit in the name of Jesus. The quickest way to get out of the presence of God is losing your patience. The quickest way to get out of the presence of God is losing patience. And so that's a spirit because you have been telling the Lord that you don't want to do it the wrong way. You want to do it the right way. Your prayers to the Lord have been that you want to wait on what he has for you, that you don't want to get in his way, but you have been getting weary and been crying out, why, God, you know, and getting tired. That has been your prayers. This is the Lord has opened up your prayer closet to me. And the Lord is telling me to let you know that, you know, just patience is a fruit of the spirit. And your time is coming. I'm not saying it is not your time now. I'm saying that some of the things that you're waiting for, you're in the season of being processed. You're being processed for the things that God wants you to have. I'm holding this so I can put my phone on the charge in a minute. So some of y'all need to connect to the power source, which is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Make sure you're connected. Somebody say, I'm connected. Make sure you're connected to the power source, which is the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings. And so, Chelsea, understand that you're just being processed. You're being processed. Be patient. Understand that God is working it all out. He's working it all out for your good. Even the person that you're desiring, God says, I'm working some things out. I'm pulling some things out of them, even while you're praying. So keep praying. Pray for what you want to see happen. Pray for what you're believing for. Let God, as you're praying, God is pruning. As you're praying, God is pruning. So just be patient. Be patient with yourself and just keep praying because your prayers are being answered. And that's a prophetic word for everyone on here. Pray like you have never prayed. Take your children in your arms and in your hands, hold hands with your children and pray with them. And just declare some things over their life. Declare some things over your life. Let me tell you, you're under an open heaven. I'm not going to give you something that God has not given me. Anytime the devil comes to try to kill, steal, or destroy, God raise up a standard against the enemy. He raise up a standard against the enemy. And that standard is your prayers will be answered. He will hear from heaven. He will heal your land. The nation is in a place of they're on their knees. The country, the world, they're on their knees. Okay? And so understand that their portals are open. Angels are moving. Matthew 7:1-1. Where are you watching me from? Somebody say prophesy. I want y'all to type that. If you don't want a word, you pull on the gift. Hallelujah. Be glorified. Hallelujah. Hola, my shendere, bro. Baltimore, Maryland. God says, I'm about to make a believer out of you. There's some things that you've been wanting God to do, and you don't even, like, your faith has not even been as strong as it should be. But let me tell you what the Bible says. The Bible says that it is the goodness of God that leads a person to repentance, which means there are times when we get stuff that we do not deserve. Just because God is so good and he gives us those things that we don't deserve in all his goodness, and it brings us to our knees. It caused us to be thankful, and it caused our faith to be stirred. And God says, woman of God, that I'm about to make a believer out of you. There's some things you have been believing God for, and he is giving you those things. Those things are being released right now. They're being released right now. And even the Lord is saying that he wants you to begin to read the four gospels and start even Matthew is not a coincidence that that's your name. He wants you to start reading in the book of Matthew. That's one of the four gospels. And God says that I'm about to start pouring things in your life, some things that you have been believing me for and you haven't seen them yet. I'm giving them to you in this next 3 months. Is going to be supernatural blessings. God is just pouring those supernatural blessings out. He's pouring them out over your life to strengthen your faith. Let me tell you something. God loves us so much, everybody. He loves us so much that he will do things for us. He will do things for us to keep us encouraged, even though he don't have to. Salvation is supposed to be enough for us. You understand? Salvation is enough for us. But and he loves you. He just wants, sometimes he just want to bless you. He's a father. You have children? Do you know how bad it feels? Yes, ma'am.
Have some noodles.
No, we're not cooking nothing else. There are times whenever you want to just bless your children, not because they did it good, not because they're being good. You just want to bless them. That's how God is. That's how God is. He just want to bless us. And what happens whenever you give your children something? If my daughter cry in the morning sometime because she don't want to go to school, as I read those things prophetically because she's a prophet, okay? And so I'll be like, okay, God, she's probably, you know, her day will probably be a little bit more challenging, so I'll pray even more. But you know what? Most of the time on those days, when I go to the store, God will remind me to get her a gift, to get her something to just make her feel more loved and more appreciated. It's not her birthday. It's not Christmas. Just give her something. You know, she like little Kinder Joy eggs or a little toy or something like that. And so sometimes when she have days like that, when I pick her up, I will just bless her with something. And the reason is because it shows the nature of our Father, that there are times when he just give us things, not because we deserve it, not because we did anything, just because he loves us. Just because he loves us. And that is what God is pouring out upon his people. He's going to give you things just because he loves you. Just because he loves you and you had a hard time. This is hard for God's people. You think God is not bothered by what his people are experiencing, being afraid, you know, churches shutting down? Do you really believe Jesus is pleased? If you know Jesus, you would know. The Bible says, do not forsake the assembling of yourselves with other believers. Jesus is not pleased. He's not. And so just because he's going to bless his people just to keep us close. He don't have to, but that's his heart. That's his name. Sometimes just to love on us. What does the Bible say? If a child asks you for a rock, you're not going to give them a snake. Or if they ask you for something, you're not going to give them a rock. You're not going to give them something that they don't want. You're going to give them better than what they expect. Mommy, all right, now.
Have some popcorn.
Somebody else going to have to pop it. But that's it. That's it, madame. That's it. Okay? And so understand that you have to understand the nature of God. When God is, children are shaking, he's shaking. I believe that, you know, the Bible says that when Jesus was on that cross, right after the veil torn, you know, everything went dark. I believe God did not even want to see what his son suffered, even though he knew that it was going to get us into eternity. I believe God did not even want to see it. It represents God just closing his eyes and opening them. That's what it represents. God, you know how the Bible says he wink at sin? God will wink at sin. It's just like that. That hurt God to see his son go through that. And so God took light away from the earth when Jesus gave up the ghost on the cross. And because of that, we have eternal life. He don't have to do anything else for us, but he does it because he loves us, and we have to show gratitude. Let me tell you something. Coming out of this, be nicer. Be a nicer person. Be a kinder person. Be a person that is more gentle. represent the King of Kings, because God is taking us into a place of blessing. I'm telling you, God is going, thank you, Holy Spirit. He said, give you things that you don't have even room enough to receive. Some of y'all going into the overflow. Y'all going to have too much of everything. Too much of everything. And this is where how God want to bless his people. Just because sometimes we go through times, tough times, just because we go through times where of uncertainty, God want to show us, baby, look here. I'm in control. I got you. I got this. That's the kind of God we serve. People get it twisted now. Don't think that you can do wrong and he won't judge you. But I appreciate it. I appreciate when God see me doing wrong and he want to correct me. That means he loves me. If somebody will not correct you whenever they are whenever you're going through something or you're doing something, they don't really love you. The Bible says God chastises those whom he loves. This is not the chastisement of God. This is an opportunity for God to show us his goodness. This is an opportunity. Somebody, you know, you need to believe God. Okay, they're giving us a stimulus package. God, I'm believing you for a vehicle. Okay, some kind of way. You're going to be a way maker for me. Get your children together. You know, tell them how much the Lord loved them. And this is all a time for God to show us his goodness, to show us how good he really is, show us his favor upon our lives. Hallelujah. Ola bandala be ita sheketele boko. No, God is a good God. And he's still in control. It doesn't matter. It looks like sometimes God just want to see if y'all will obey the laws of the land. Or you going to listen to these people? These people said stay in the house. The Bible said that have rule over you. If you're supposed to stay in the house, stay in the house. Because anyway, they don't have no bread at the grocery store. Went to the store today, they ain't have no bread. The kind of sausage I like. They ain't have no sausage. I said, well, I should have stayed home. And then the people was looking at me like they was crazy. Because when I left the house, I put the triple antibody ointment in my nose. I put it on. Y'all not about to have me out here bent, but I had to go to the store. Look here, quit talking. Go ahead. I'm going to fix it. Come sit down right here and listen to the preaching of the gospel because God want to touch you tonight. Come on. Listen. Believe God for it. He'll give it to you. And business will open up to you. There are people that planted that $1,000 seed and God gave them business ideas and they didn't do anything with it. And so you still have your seed in the ground. It's time for you to do something with it. You should never stop. So you should always be believing and be sowing. As a matter of fact, I saw with my Amazon Prime, they want to give me a book about some kind of supernatural seed sowing. So I'm going to do a study on that, and then I want to release that and let people learn, you know, a little bit more about it. But listen, I'm telling y'all, I feel it so deep down in my spirit that God is about to do something supernatural, and God has been encouraging me. There's some things that God has told me that he wanted me to do. Even last year when we made vision boards, God had even told me, and I told you guys that took the right division class, that God said some of those things is going to take 2 years to complete. And so some of those things. Lessons. Let me tell you something. In order to march, there got to be some movement. But let me tell you about marching. When you're marching, you do it in a systematic manner. It's one foot in front of the other. It is consistent. It's concise. You have to be precise, and that means you're moving like a soldier. That means you don't have your own mind. There's only one king, and so you don't have your own mind. You move at the beat of God's drum. That means you walk by faith. That means you move forward without thinking, but by faith, believing in the report of the Lord. God is going to do something great. God is going to do something supernatural. I'm walking into my blessings. Things are God. My gift is going to make room for me. What are you speaking over your life? What are you speaking over your life? I'm telling you. I'm telling y'all. Y'all going to see? Y'all, oh, shake it there. When y'all see it, y'all going to say, she said it. God is doing some big things. He's working behind the scenes. I know my God, and I know what I've been praying for. I know what I've been talking to him about, and I know he answered. One of the first things God showed me, even before he told me, well, he told me I was a prophet, but I didn't understand exactly what he was meaning, but he was showing me the ability to see. He called me a seer first. That's what he told me. My first encounter with God, when I first heard his voice, he called me a seer, and he told me by pointing out an eye and telling me about calls and conversations. Okay, and then the very next lesson that he taught me was how much he answered my prayers. He showed me how he answered my prayers time and time again. And it was a time where it hurt. It hurt because he answered that prayer. And it was a prayer that I knew I could not change. But when God gave me the results, it hurt me. It hurt me to my core, but it made me who I am. And so I'm telling y'all, let me tell you, God is about to do something supernatural for you. And you better hold on. You better hold on. You better hold on. Some of y'all need, I'm going to just call Lazarus. Lazarus, come forth in the name of Jesus. I'm calling you out of your grave clothes right now in the name of Jesus. I command the best of you to come forth now in the name of Jesus. I command every Lazarus on this broadcast to rise up, to come forth in the name of Jesus. The best part of your life is just about to happen. The greatest things that God put on the inside of you are just about to manifest. You just hold on. You just hold on. You hold on to the unchanging hand of God. The devil is a liar. Everything the devil is trying to destroy, I just command and prophesy. God is going to give us back 100-fold. The devil is a lie. For everything that the devil tries to steal, kill, or destroy, I speak 100-fold return over it in the name of Jesus. The devil is a liar. Then God is a multiplier. The devil is a liar and God is a multiplier. Everything the devil think he's taking, God going to give us back double for our trouble. He's going to give us back double. I know him. I know the master. I know him firsthand. I have meetings with him. I have encounters with him. He talked to me. He walked with me. God is going to give us double for our trouble. The devil is a lie. He should have let them people move fast and let them continue to travel and not lock down the city. He messed up. He messed up. Because the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. And I know I've been sending up some prayers to heaven. And I know you have been sending up some prayers to heaven. And I'm telling you that we're under an open heaven. So you need to be sending up some prayers. God is about to give you some things that you don't even have room enough to receive. You don't even have room enough to receive it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know who Christine is. I don't know who Christine is. If you Christine or you have a Christine in your house, God said, I'm healing Christine. So I don't know who you are. I didn't see nobody with that name, but I just heard the Lord say, I'm healing somebody named Christine. So whoever you are, Christine, receive your healing. If that's your cousin or your auntie or your uncle, God is healing. Don't mind me. So I just pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. Pray for restoration. We just commit it to be prepared right now in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, move like never before, Lord God. Your mom. Okay, what is wrong with your mama? I'm going to tell her maybe something going on with her that she don't know, or she didn't tell you. But you just tell her God said he's healing her. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, that's right. Amen. And that's what he does. And I tell people, it's so important that you have a prayer routine. Because, and I use my books. To do strategic prayers. If you go to my website, prophetessvictoria.com, I have a lot of ebooks. Especially if you are called into ministry, you need to have breaking opposition, the breeze, and you need to pray that. And you need to pray it, you know, at times of warfare, okay? But I know that even based on the scripture that the woman of God just gave, and God said, I'm about to multiply. Where are you? I'm about to multiply you. So whenever you're praying, God will give you downloads. Oh, that's a blessing. Bless her. Put your hand on her head and just speak the blessing over her. I transfer the anointing on my life on her life as you lay your hands on her. But God had gave me that word to release to the people that while you're praying, if God know that he can find you praying at 8:30 every day, that's the time you pray. He know he can find you praying. He will speak to you while you're praying. Even while you're praying, God will begin to give you words of knowledge, words of wisdom. He'll begin to tell you what you're supposed to be doing. You're supposed to be, are we doing a fast going, doing the lockdown? I don't know what you're talking about. If God needs you to fast, then fast. We did the fast the other day. We can pray about the virus. And look at this. God said it was going to disappear suddenly. And now all of a sudden, I think the next day, no cases in China. So it's just going to have to spread all over the nation. It's just going to have to spread all over the nation. Alicia, God says, continue to be faithful. He said, continue to be faithful. You're faithful over a few things. I'll make you ruler over many. God said, your increase is coming. Your time of darkness and despair is gone. And I just break that spirit of darkness and despair off of your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, God said that your season of darkness and despair is over. Increase is coming. Your faithfulness has paid a way for something new in your life. Hallelujah. Everybody just needs to say it. I serve an extraordinary God. He's extraordinary. He's extraordinary. Somebody just need to say that to the Lord. Go write down your prophetic word. You got a prophetic word? And I just pray double for your trouble, Romania. I just pray double for your trouble. I see your seed. Yeah, all things new. You saw seed and it had a number 8 in it. And just know that God is going to, he's turning some things around. All things new. All things new. Just understand. I just need you to speak that over your life. I serve an extraordinary God. He's extraordinary. He's doing something great. He's doing something great in your life. While you're praying, open heaven. You're under an open heaven. Begin to pray. Begin to pray and allow the Lord to give you things that you begin to say what you want to see happen and not what you're seeing happen. The devil is a lie. Erica, God says that I'm favoring you. I've never removed the level of favor that I have over you, and the warfare that you are experiencing is just because the breakthrough. You're in a breakthrough season. Anytime ground have to break, there has to be some shaking. So do not let this move your faith. Do not be shaken, says the Spirit of the living God. Do not be shaken by what you're experiencing. It's not to shake you. The ground is breaking for your blessings. The ground is breaking for your miracles. Lauren, I saw you on here. God says you can expect your business to expand. The Spirit of the Lord says, Lauren, that there's an expansion coming to your business. I don't know if you've been looking over your business plan or trying to improvise or what you've been doing, but there's an expansion coming to your business, says the Spirit of the living God. Hallelujah. The favor of God is going to overtake your life, Dishay. God says, my favor is going to overtake your life. You have not seen it yet. You've been praying for it. You've been believing for it. You have not seen it. But God said you will experience it. You will feel it. It's just a lot of suddenlies coming. Somebody else need to receive that word for themselves, that the suddenlies of God is overtaking my life. The suddenlies of God is overtaking my life. Hallelujah. Jamidria, I don't know if you've been trying to lose weight or you're believing God. or you're believing God, but I hear the Lord saying something about supernatural weight loss. So if you're planning on going on a diet or something that you're trying to do, God is, I see heaven assisting you. Things new. Expect the supernatural. So I don't know if you've been believing God for that, but you're going to drop some weight. I just received that for myself. Let me just quit taking prednisone and the weight just fall off in Jesus' name. Ooh, glory. Pray for me, y'all. I have to take it. But let God be Lord over it. The suddenlies. God is going to blow your mind. Yes, Lord. Oh, my shekete. Oh, do no moko. Pour me out a blessing. Oro boko shende le makashe de kete tete shete tete de bo. Oro godo lo boko shanda la mekes kete le boko. Braka sanda la mekes kete le boko. Uda ba sete kete le boko. Somebody said prophesy. Hallelujah. Be. And it's gonna be. My future is big. Somebody needs to say that. My destiny is big. My promise is big. Yes, Lord. Oba shende le manda la brende gede bogoshkotoloboko. Braka sakatala bike. Janae, God says everything has been very still in your life at this time, says the Spirit of the Living God. God says, but as soon as yours is on the other side.
Mine's dead.
Okay, go charge it on the side of the sofa. Jayshawn, come get up. We can help with this charger. God says that everything has been at a standstill in your life. But as soon as you have your baby, you can expect to walk into double portion blessings. You're going to have double portion blessings just overtake you. So you and Jamar, just hold on tight. God says everything has kind of been at a standstill. But as soon as you have your baby, God says, I'm blessing and I'm multiplying. I'm blessing and I'm multiplying. Hallelujah. So just expect it. Just go through this. God doesn't want you to be overwhelmed. He doesn't want you to, you know, to doubt. He doesn't want you to be afraid. And God says, I'm even going to begin to show you in dreams the direction that I want you to go. I'm even going to show you in dreams the direction. Amen. I'm going to show you in dreams the direction I want you to go. Money, cars, the baby, everything will come all at one time. You have not got edible shokoto. God says, I did not give you a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. So walk in the power that God has given you, which means that you cannot fail. It means that nothing is greater than the ability that God has given you. Nothing. Power and love. Love everyone and love you. Love everyone and love you. And a sound mind. That means when the enemy come in to play with your mind, you have to cast it down. You cast every wrong spirit and wrong thought that try to exalt itself above the knowledge of God. The knowledge of God is God wants you blessed. He wants you walking. He wants you healed. He wants you favored. He wants you ministering, being able to minister the gospel. He wants you to be able to show someone else love. He wants you to be able to be happy, to have peace. That's the will of God for his children. He wants us to walk in power. He wants us to walk in miracles and signs and wonders. Who is Shante? Is there somebody on here named Shante? I don't know why I'm here, Shante. That's my middle name. But is there anybody else on here named Shante?
Pour me out a blessing.
Everybody type something so I can see your names and see if the Lord want me to tell you something before. Jamidra, you never said that if you was believing God to lose some weight off, that was in your thoughts, or what was that? Why is God saying that? And then God is even saying that it's double. It's double fold. That some of the responsibility, you're going to drop the heaviness of responsibility. Because God is putting more on your husband. He's putting more on your husband and giving him more to do. So it's the spiritual weight and his weight in the natural. God said it's double fold. Verbal, God just told me to tell you that there are blessings coming in your life. There's blessings coming in your life. He said, just give him praise. I even see you in the realms of the spirit at your home. I see you at your home cooking and dancing with gospel music on. So let that be. If you're not doing that now, or if you're doing that, then I'm confirming it with this word that God is about is coming to your home to bless you, because I see you dancing in your kitchen while you're cooking and cleaning, just being very happy. But I want you to make sure that that is something that you are doing, that you just you lift up praises before the Lord in your house. Just lift them up. Ola banda ishekete le brondo. Oko tolo boko shandala mekeskete. Broko shandala mekeskete le boko. Broko shandala mekeskete. Brenda, where is Brenda? Brenda, are you, where are you, Brenda? Are you laying in your bed and you have a, are you laying in your bed listening to me? Oko shandele makashandala mekeskete de brondo. Ora bresekete de broko shkotolo boko shandala meke. Broko. Lord have mercy. Thank you, Jesus. Let me not get upset about it. Why God take me into the people's bedroom? I rebuke that spirit of panic off of you. What city are you in, Brenda? Olobo shendelema. I see a black dresser. I don't know your bedroom set. I see a black dresser. A flower. God said you're sitting over there in panic, but I cancel that spirit of fear off of you. In the name of Jesus, God told me to just speak peace over your life, South Carolina. I speak the peace of God that surpasses all understanding over your life. In Jesus' name. See anybody there? I don't see. God is going to work a miracle for you. God is going to work a miracle for you. Ogolobo shandalame. Odorobo shiketetetekeshiketelebuko. I don't know if you're laboring over marriage or praying for marriage or you're going through something in your marriage or what it is, you know, but marriage blessing that God is releasing over your life.
It's my season.
I like this song. Let me do this one. Brenda, are you still there? You didn't run out of room, huh? Because I came in the room. Miss Vera, I hear in the realms of the spirit that God is giving you another job. I don't know if it's a promotion on the inside of the job that you have, but there is another job that's coming for you. It looks like it's going to be like within the next 30 to 45 days. There's another job that's God is giving you. And it's going to bring you more finances. God says, I'm removing some of the financial burden off of your life with this new job. Hallelujah. Ms. Vera, God told me to tell you your prayers have been answered. You pray all the time, Lord, Jesus, this job, Lord. This is how I hear you in the spirit. Lord Jesus, this job, Lord, this job, help me, Lord. God says your prayers have been answered. He's giving you another job. At the mention of your name, every knee will bow. You are Lord. I tried circulating the song you played. Got it, I forgot. Okay.
You are Lord. Sickness has to bow. At the mention of your name.
Oh, okay. Bless you.
You are.
What by faith? What city are you in? I'm seeing an angel that they gave the city. And you need to go your fastest. And God is one that I'm in the world because in that city. You're going to be the one that's going to fast. Tomorrow, it needs to be at least 24 hours that you fast. Brodo bo shekete le manda ishkete kete le boko. Let the scales fall from the eyes of your people, God. Let them see your glory. Let them see your glory. Let everything block in their ear gates, God, from hearing you, God. Let them be open now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. Some of y'all have to protect y'all gates. Some of y'all are exposed to too much. You listen to too much and you're seeing too much. And I'm not talking about the news. I'm talking about people who's cursing. Filth. Some of y'all don't understand that the anointing on your life is quenched because of the filth that you're around. So you have to learn how to turn people off. Teach people how to respect you, okay? Let me tell you, I got them grays in my head, baby. You have to respect me. I got a couple of ears. I look a little young in the face because of the Indian blood. But listen up here. I got grays here. I got a little wisdom, too. And I got the gift of wisdom. But listen. Y'all have to teach some people. Look here. You're not going to curse around me like that. I'm a woman of God. I'm a man of God. I don't want to hear that. My angel can't move with me because you got a nasty mouth. You know? Then rebuke yourself too if you're doing it. I'm telling y'all. You gotta learn how to teach people to treat you. And y'all about to get into some relationships. Because let me tell you something. These men are scared. These men, they scared and they lonely. They lonely. Okay? They lonely. So these men is going to be looking for these wives coming out of this coronavirus situation. God just told them they don't want to be alone. They up here acting hard like they, you know. But God is teaching these men, you don't want to be alone while you're saying this. And you're stuck in the house and can't go eat at the restaurant. So they're going to come looking. They're going to come looking. I'm telling y'all. And y'all has to be ready. You better know what you got to tell them. Know what you need. Know what you need. Know what you won't settle for. Anything they kind of ain't treat you do any kind of way, do any kind of, you gotta set the standard. They looking, they thirsty. That's one thing I keep on saying, Lord have mercy. These men, they in the coronavirus, but they on the app still checking for these women. They ain't sleeping. They not sleeping. You go out and you put your red thing on, like my spiritual father say. Prophet Passion Java. You put your red lipstick on. Okay? They're gonna be looking. And y'all that's married, quit running around here looking like these momos, okay? Y'all better make it cute. Sister, you was cute today, too. I meant to tell you that. I'm telling y'all. Some of them don't know what they need, but Corona, COVID-19 is showing them what they need. You can't go to the restaurant and get you no burgers. Having paying them people to cook for you. I'll show you. Saying what the Lord is saying. I'm telling you, God, some of y'all need to raise your hand too low. Some of y'all need to raise your hand too low. Hallelujah. Jesus. Just call his name right there in your home. Jesus. Jesus. Yes, Lord. You Lord over sickness. You Lord over COVID. You Lord. Is it breaking up? Okay, go ahead now. Is it breaking up? Well, it might be time for me to go. Because it did better than I thought. I was probably going to have to do it tomorrow. But listen up. God have great things in store for his people. This devil is a lie, but it's work. I'm telling y'all, I know God. I know him. I know him for myself. I can't go off of what my mama taught me because my mama taught us how to pray the novena and pray the rosary. Listen up. I'm telling you, I know him for myself. And some of y'all, you can't go by what your mama know and what your daddy know. You have to get a relationship with yourself. And when these times come, you'll understand. And relationship come from hunger. You can read the Bible every single day, but that ain't going to make you gotta desire him. You gotta want to be intimately acquainted with him. Smith Wigglesworth, he would throw the baby against the he threw a baby against the wall. The baby would stop breathing. He threw the baby against the wall. The baby hit the floor. The baby came back to life. Sometimes he wouldn't sit down. He sit down with that Bible, and that Bible was his food. And not only that, his main prayer was to God more. To know God more. God more. I want to know you. I want to be intimately acquainted with you. And that's how fire. That's how we get the glory. That's how we get miracles, signs, and wonders. Whenever we want to know God and be intimately acquainted himself. And some of y'all need to understand that, yes, you've been believing God to heal certain things in your life. You know, like it's something that you're dealing with. You believe in God to heal it. But God knows if I take that thorn out of your flesh, if I take that one thorn out of your flesh, you're not gonna watch after yourself. You're not gonna pay attention to what you're eating. You're not gonna pay attention to what you're doing. I have to keep this thorn in your flesh as a buffer, like he did for the apostle. I keep that there so you can be aware how to walk, how to talk, how to eat, and what to do. So sometimes God put a slight affliction. Seems like an affliction, but it's really to keep you on track. It's really to make sure that you understand that, yes, you're human. You're with me, and I'm with you. But this is the only thing that's going to keep you aware. When God knew that he could trust me with trouble, the sky became has not the sky became of you and not the limit. But when God can't trust you with trouble, he can't trust you to be consistent. He can't trust you to pray without needing something. You're not ready for the big, which is the blessings in God. B-I-G, blessings in God. You're not ready for the big until God knows that you can be consistent when you're in trouble. Now, I'm not saying he won't bless you, because what these people are trying to do to us is only going to push God's children closer to him. And it's only going to push God to a place where he want to bless his children so much that it caused him to be mad. That's what God is going to do. But there, you have to get to a place where you want more of God. And you say, God, whatever you give me, I give it back to you. Whatever you give me, I will give it back to you. And that's how God know I can give you anything and you'll surrender it back to me. God know he can give me $100,000 a year because he know I'm going to tithe more than $10,000. He know I'm a tithe. My tithe will be up there $15,000 to $20,000. If he gives me $100,000 in a year, God gives some people $13,000 in a year, and the church can't get $1,300. God can't trust you. He can't trust you. But he already did his part, and our job is to believe that when Jesus did it, he paid it all, and now we have to walk in it. Now we have to walk in what Jesus gave us. Jesus gave us peace. When he died, he gave us healing. He gave us the gifts of the Spirit. He gave us opportunities to be business owners. He gave us the opportunity to be so close to him that we can literally feel him touching us. This time when I'm in my prayer time with God and I'm meeting the Lord, Jesus, one time I went to Jesus, I say, look, I'm sick. I'm not feeling good. Jesus laid his hand in the spirit realm. You travel in the spirit. And Jesus laid his hand on me, and in the bed, I just laid out. I didn't even remember going to sleep after the encounter, but he laid me out. And it's biblical. Okay, who knocked Apostle Paul off his horse? Nobody. Jesus, right there from heaven. We need to believe for these supernatural encounters from God. We need to have these times with him for ourselves, that we can walk into these running over blessings. But these running over blessings come because we're flowing in a running over anointing. And that's where God wants you. That's where he pour his oil, where there is a cry for him. If you are an intercessor and you have not got on your face before the Lord and cried out to him to give his people peace, in this time, you're not an intercessor. And you're sleeping on your job and you're hindering yourself. You need to, how are you going to be an intercessor and you have not got on your face before the Lord crying out for his people? Literally crying. God, help your people. Your people are hurting. Your people are longing for a move. You can't be an intercessor and have not cried out and made petitions for God's people to him. But if you have, you can expect the blessings of God to overtake you. And if you do it, you can expect it, because that's all he wants, is to be acknowledged, to be talked to. You think God don't get lonely? God created heaven for us. It's because he wanted his people with him. He wanted his people with him. He didn't need us. He wanted us. Jesus went through that because God wanted us to be with him in eternity. And that's why he's jealous. That's why he watch over our moves. He pay attention to our prayers. It's because he wanted a world where his people are all together, that he take care of his people, that the Bible says that we will rejoice all day. There's no night because of the glory of God there. God did that because he wanted a kingdom for his people. And Jesus got us back in. So we can't be ignorant of Satan's devices. These things that is going on now that we see is a device of Satan, is a device of the enemy, trying to cause division, trying to cause us to lose focus, trying to cause us to be, you lose focus and be distracted, trying to cause us to give up hope. That's a lie. This is the time to stand by faith and not by sight, to walk in it. And not walk in it being a clown. Oh, I'm gone, baby. I'm coronavirus. Won't touch me. It won't touch you. But don't go into places that you know you're not supposed to be. You still have to use wisdom.
Obo shendele makanda ishekedele bokoshko toloboko. Broko shekete. And I just break the spirit of fear. I want you to go and get your water. I'm just going to pray some things and release the blessing. I break the spirit of fear off of your life in the name of Jesus. I break the spirit of doubt right now. I command doubt to go. I command you to loose your hold off of God's people tonight in Jesus' name. I command that fear of poverty, that spirit of poverty that's plaguing the nations, I command it to go now. I command the spirit of lack to go now in the name of Jesus. I command every spirit of separation to be blocked by the fire of God in the name of Jesus. I command blind eyes to be opened now in the name of Jesus by the fire of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' mighty name. Every spirit of loneliness, I command a turnaround. I command a turnaround right now that loneliness will become a place of healing, a place of peace in the name of Jesus, that there will not be loneliness. I command the spirit of singleness to go now in the name of Jesus. That word must have been for me. Go ahead, God, do it. Hallelujah. I never heard somebody come back on and say if there was a Shante on here. Hallelujah. Every demon power that's fighting the assignment of God over our lives, we scatter it now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. The Lord Jesus rebuke you. You spirit of sickness, of infirmity, the Lord Jesus rebukes you in the name of Jesus. Spirit of worry, I command you to go now. I command you to loose God's people now in the name of Jesus. I command you to go back to the pits of hell in Jesus' mighty name. The spirit of crying that is not prophetic crying, I command it to go now in the name of Jesus. If it's not a cleansing or purification or curses being broken, I command that spirit of sorrow to go in the mighty name of Jesus. The spirit of being locked up, things having you in bondage, I command it to be broken now. Nothing shall have you in bondage or in lockdown. I command it to go now in the name of Jesus. I command you to be free. The Bible says, he whom the Son set free is free indeed in Jesus' name. I command the spirit of suffering to go now in Jesus' name. I heard so many people saying that they're having earaches. I just cancel pain in the ear in the name of Jesus. Lord, let the people hear your good news. Let good news, God. Let good news come to your people now in the name of Jesus. I command every demon of power holding your people captive to go in the name of Jesus. I command them to come out by fire in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God touch, Lord God, right now in Jesus' mighty name. The blood of Jesus. I speak the blood of Jesus over you. The blood of Jesus over your home. I just put the blood of Jesus over your doorpost, and not your firstborn or your lastborn will be touched. In the mighty name of Jesus. The spirit of terror. We cancel the spirit of terror in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The name above every name. In Jesus' mighty name. The name where all the power is, the name where every demon have to go, in the mighty name of Jesus, we cancel that spirit now in Jesus' name. The spirit of infirmity, God, we send it to the pits of hell. We send it to the pits of hell in Jesus' name. Every unstable demon, the demon that's causing instability, we cancel you by the fire of the Holy Ghost. We bind you in chains of fire and send you to the pits of hell. Every spirit that is causing you to be shaken or driven by anything other than the Holy Ghost, we command that power to be broken off of your life now in the mighty name of Jesus. You unstable spirit, I bind you. The Bible says we bind on earth to be bound in heaven, and whatever we loose on earth to be loosed in heaven. And I just command you to be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord in Jesus' name. You spirit of instability, I cancel you by the fire of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' mighty name. You spirit of anxiety, we curse you at the root in the name of Jesus. We just pluck you up and send you to the pits of hell. In Jesus' mighty name.
Brondo Isheketeleboko. We cancel the spirit of fear right now and doubt. We cancel it now in the name of Jesus. I release the fire of God in Jesus' name. I release the fire of God that you will not be lacked concerning reading the Bible. You will not be slacked in your prayer life. You will not be slacked in your faith. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Fire, Holy Ghost fire. I release the fire of God right now. Let fire begin to travel all over your body. I release the fire of God in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God manifest right now in Jesus' name. I release it right now. Ododobo shekete. Itatata la braka. Shekete le brondo. Broko shekete le branda katala beke. Let your mind be renewed as the fire of the Holy Ghost touch you. I just release the renewal of your mind right now. In Jesus' name, that you begin to see things clearly. You begin to hear the voice of the Lord clearly. You begin to have better understanding in the name of Jesus. Let there be a refreshing and a renewal right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we give you honor and praise in Jesus' mighty name. Otorobo ndolomanda. Ete ketele boko. Rorobo sheketele mandara bro. Uta la brande kede skete ketele buko shokoto lo buko. Branda kasanda la beke skete. Valencia, I don't know what Raheem is planning on doing, but the Lord is showing me that there's a promotion coming to him. There's a promotion coming to Raheem. God is about to increase him. There's a new level of increase, and I just break the chain that is causing him to be separated from his child. I command that chain to be broken now. Every demonic chain trying to separate him from his firstborn, I command the fire of God to break that struggle in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I command that spirit plaguing you, Sabrina, to go to the pits of hell. I send angels of fire all around your home that the devil will not be able to penetrate, throw his voice, or use demonic devices to speak to you in the name of Jesus. We cancel every monitoring spirit off of the lives of God's people tonight. Let every monitoring spirit go to the pits of hell. Every demon that is causing God's people terror or fear or calamity or causing dreams to be blocked, we scatter you by the fire of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' mighty name. Janae, I don't know where Jamarik is, but I see an angel that's standing there behind him and touching him on the right shoulder. God is anointing him for kingship. There's something new that the Lord is doing in his life. God is changing. God is changing the way that he think. God is changing the way that he process things, and God is changing his demeanor. I don't know where he is right now, but there's an angel touching him. So there's change coming to his complete. He's going to tell you that something happened to him. Don't ask him. He's going to come and tell you. Something happened to me. I'm feeling different. I saw an angel touch him on his right shoulder. Yes, Lord. Fire of God and blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Broko sandala bekeskete. I release it to him in the name of Jesus. Let him go to a job that brings him much peace, and let him find himself in the will of the Father. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We break every chain, Lord God, that is causing your people to be stuck to anything that you have not assigned to their life. We command chains to be broken now in the name of Jesus. I was praying with Raheem earlier for everything you just read. Hallelujah. Let the Lord be magnified. Broko, even Miss Marion, I don't know what your husband is doing, but God is saying that even there's a promotion coming to him. There's a promotion coming to your husband. And I see in the realm of the spirit that there is an angel that's clothing him with a robe. There's a robe, like a robe of righteousness. So there's something that he's doing or he's getting ready to do that is very pleasing to God. So it's like God has given him like lordship or rulership as well. So there's a fresh anointing coming over his life now. And God said that he is opening up his eyes to understand who he is in the spirit realm, because he don't really understand who he is. He's so stuck in the past, thinking about things in the past that happened to him, keeping him torn and perplexed. Yes, yes. But there's an anointing that God is giving him.
Odoloma shakata la beke se kitele brondo. Broko shite kitele broko. Yes, Harold. Thank you, Lord. Lord, touch every man that is assigned to every woman on this broadcast and in this house where I am, God. Bad stuff happens. Okay, well, then there's a new level of glory. See, that's how God does it. When something happened, it happened because God is doing a transition. There's something coming. Hallelujah. The storm is over. But Lord, anoint every man, Lord God, for every woman that you have on this broadcast. Break them free from the chains that's keeping them bound in the mighty name of Jesus. Let every demonic hole, every wrong relationship that's binding them to something wrong, let the power of that thing be broken now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, let your will begin to go through their mind like never before. Put your will on the forefront, Lord God, that they need holy, godly wives. And I just pray for every man on here that's dealing with a rebellious woman or with a Jezebel spirit, that that power over that woman will be broken in Jesus' name. If you are a woman on here and you're married and your husband is still in a soul tie, we command that those ties to be broken now in the name of Jesus. Let every man in your life that is connected to something in the past that's keeping them in bondage, I command that power to be broken tonight in the name of Jesus. Let them be loose tonight by the fire of the Holy Ghost. And we say, Jesus, to sever every chain of every yoke of bondage that they are connected to in the name of Jesus. Let them be set free. Let them be set free. Jesus, the word says you came to set the captives free. Set all the blood of Jesus. It speaks, Lord God, of greater promises. Let them walk into greater promises and let every chain that they are stuck into be broken. Let the chain be broken now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. I had a dream that God said in my ears what God has put together, that no man put asunder. Amen. That's the reason. He told you that for a reason. Spirit of backwardness, take broken off your life right now in the name of Jesus. I command every spirit of backwardness or confusion to be broken off of his life in the name of Jesus Christ. Some of y'all are going to start having open visions. You'll be driving down the road and you're going to start having open visions. God is going to show you some things. And all these things will happen days. We're here tonight. So I'm so confused about what happened tonight. Then he wrote the word. Okay, message me and tell me what that word means. You just had an open vision? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Your open vision will happen in 7 days. As you begin to have a vision, it'll happen within 7 days. To your Lord. Bless your holy name, Jesus.